Hello everyone, my name is future PhD, Dr. E, and you're watching Putting the U Back into Graduate School. And this series is for you if one, you want to be a grad student and you don't know where to start, or two, you're interested about becoming a grad student and you want to know more. So for this week's topic, we're going to talk about, is grad school for me? And if it is, what things should you be looking for grad school? So, what is grad school? Grad school is short for graduate school, and programs are generally between 1 and 3 years. What grad school does is change a specialty into an expertise. And you might be wondering what the difference between grad school is from typical four-year bachelor's degree, and I'm going to show you. I call this the Circle of Knowledge, and the Circle of Knowledge was adapted by MapMind's Illustrated Guide to a PhD. This box you see here is all the knowledge of the entire universe, things we have yet to learn. And in this smaller circle here is the total knowledge of all humans. This can mean anything such as languages, this can mean music, this can mean sports, this can mean anything you can think of that all humans have learned up to this point is within this circle. And if you look at this blue circle, this is knowledge that you learned from pre-K to pre-high school. As you can see, it's a circle, and this is just because you have very generalizable information about the world. You've learned your first language here, you learn how to do basic math and writing here. And if you go on into high school, you see this green circle. And this green circle is getting more advanced topics of these general ideas. In high school, you may have learned a second language that's in here. You may have learned more advanced mathematics. You may have learned how to play an instrument here. And then you'll get to undergrad, you get into college, and you still continue to develop more information. The difference between college and high school is, you can see this bump. This bump represents your major, and this becomes your specialty. For example, I got my undergrad in chemical engineering, and my bump right here becomes things about engineering, such as chemistry, physics, advanced math. And then when you go to grad school, most specifically your master's, you don't have a round circle anymore. It becomes more of an oval shape. And this is the transition between your specialty and your expertise. During your master's, you'll start to get more advanced knowledge in a specific field. But the key difference is your knowledge isn't as broad, but your knowledge is much deeper. So with all this in mind, you might be wondering, why should I go to grad school? And well, I have three reasons why you should go to grad school. One, a job you want to do requires it. Some jobs require an advanced degree, and the only way you're going to get an advanced degree is by going to grad school. Two, it might give you an extra credential to separate yourself from other colleagues. Some companies respect an advanced degree, and they might be able to get a promotion, or you might be able to get a raise for your degree. And three is, it allows you to go into a different field. For example, I had a buddy of mine who was in psychology and he really wanted to do computer science. And by going to grad school and getting his master's degree in computer science, he was now eligible for all of these new jobs in the computer science field. So even though grad school offers a lot of value, it doesn't offer a lot of value for everyone, and there's many reasons why you shouldn't go to grad school. The first reason why you should go to grad school is, first, is cost. Graduate school can be very expensive and doesn't necessarily increase your earning potential. So you should only go to grad school if that's something you really know you want to do for your career, or that's something you really want to do. The second thing that I don't like about grad school is it's very difficult and it's very time consuming. And for those in your 20s, you may have other dreams and aspirations you want to pursue. You really don't have that flexibility or freedom of time to pursue that in graduate school. So if there's something you want to do that you're more passionate about, I think you should pursue that before going to grad school. The third thing is overqualification. Overqualification is where you're no longer qualified
grad school will overqualify you for a lot of positions you are interested in right now, but it does qualify you for other positions. So if you like what you're doing, I don't think you should go to grad school. You should only go to grad school if there's something that you need grad school to do a job that you want to do. So now that we know a few pros and cons about graduate school, I'm going to talk to you about the difference between a master's and a PhD. The biggest difference is between a master's and a PhD is a master's is if you want to learn a lot about the field, and a PhD is when you want to contribute to the field. So in addition to classes, a PhD will also take a research component in order to change the field in a different direction. So what does that mean? Well, we're going to take another look at the circle of knowledge. Last time we saw the circle of knowledge, we learned the difference between getting an expertise from a master's degree versus getting a specialty from an undergraduate degree. And now we're going to look into how a PhD differs from a master's degree. As you get your PhD, your knowledge base becomes even more specialized than it was from master's, and you get closer and closer to the limit of human knowledge. As the years go by, you start pushing towards that boundary of human knowledge. And you keep pushing and pushing, and then eventually you'll break past what is currently known into unknown territory. And then that's when you're ready to get your PhD. Even though it's very minor, you have to keep in mind that a lot of other students are getting their PhD, so that's collectively pushing the boundary of human knowledge even further, and I think that's pretty cool. So now that we know the differences between a PhD and a master's, you might be wondering if you should get a PhD or a master's, and I'm going to talk about the advantages of getting a master's. A master's, one, is faster than a PhD. Masters can take between 1 or 3 years full-time, while a PhD is typically 4 to 7 years. So if you want to go back into the workforce, getting a master's is definitely for you. Secondly is, a master's is more flexible in terms of opportunities and in choice. In terms of opportunities, getting a master's, unlike a PhD, you don't have a true expertise yet, so you can definitely go around and get different jobs. And for a PhD, even though you know much more, your knowledge base is so specialized, companies wouldn't necessarily trust you in areas outside your expertise, unlike a master's. And the third reason I talked about was flexibility. If you want to go in and get a master's and then leave out work and then go for a PhD, you can do that. But if you get a PhD and you find out that you don't like your areas of expertise, you typically don't go back to get a second PhD. Getting second and third PhDs are very unheard of. Even though getting a master's offers a lot of advantages, that doesn't mean that having a PhD has no value. In my opinion, getting a PhD has a lot more value than getting a master's, and I'm about to tell you why. The first reason is a PhD forces you to do things other people don't, so you're able to do things other people can't. And this allows you to think at a much higher level than a lot of master's or bachelor degree holders. And this can be very lucrative. A lot of PhDs become consultants, and consultants can bring you a lot of money if that's what you like making. The second reason is most PhD programs are fully funded, so you're essentially getting paid to think. And there's not a lot of opportunities that provide you that, paid at least. And the third reason is getting a PhD, since you're contributing to the field, you get to work with a lot of interesting and complex problems, and not many jobs give you the opportunity to do that. So once you reach this point, if you're not sure between if you want a PhD or a master's, I definitely recommend getting a master's degree, because you can always have the option to get a PhD later. Or if you're really curious about research, I would suggest getting a master's degree with a research component, or getting a master's degree and do volunteer research. So that way you can get the feel of a PhD lifestyle without actually committing to it. Hopefully by this point, you definitely want to go to grad school, which leaves the big question, how do I choose a grad school? And that's a great question to have. But before I start talking about the things you should be looking at grad schools, I want you to consider this. You should choose a grad school that fits best for you, and only you, not your parents, not your mentors, not your community, just you. Because when you're going through the day-to-day and you choose a grad school that wasn't best for you but for someone else, grad school can be more difficult than it actually has to be. And with that in mind, we're going to talk about the first thing you need to consider about going to grad school, and that's the program. One of the top things you should consider when choosing a graduate school is the program. You should definitely choose a graduate school which interests you. On top of that, you should want to consider the funding sources for each program. For master's students, you're generally unfunded. However, some schools have more money and they're able to support you and give you fellowships and scholarships, which is able to reduce tuition significantly. For PhD students, you also want to look at the funding sources, because some programs only have 2 years of secured funding, while other schools have 5 or 6 years of funding. The next thing you want to consider for graduate school is environment. Now, when I say member environment, I mean, what kind of things do you want to do? Do you like fishing? Do you like hunting? Do you like horseback riding? If so, going to a graduate school in the city probably isn't the best for you. On the other hand, if you like driving, if you like the energy of the city, if you like walking down city streets, you probably don't want to go to a graduate school in a rural area. Although there's no perfect choice, you definitely want to choose the choice best for you. Cost of living is another big factor. A lot of people want to live in big cities because big cities are very fun and have a lot of things to do. But because of that, big cities are also typically more expensive. PhD students usually make $2,500 to $3,000 a month, and in cities like LA, San Francisco, or New York, rent can be anywhere between $3,000 and $6,000 a month. So if you become a grad student in one of these cities, you're probably going to need a lot of roommates. This may be a problem, or this may not, depending on your own goals. This is definitely something you should keep in mind. For PhD students, one thing you should consider is the advisor matching process. And as far as I know, there are two advisor matching processes. One is rotation. The rotation style allows students to rotate between different lab groups, and they're able to make connections with different lab members and find out what project they really want to take on. The disadvantage of this style is there may not be space for this research group you really want to work in. Alternatively, there is the direct match system, in which you are able to be directly matched into a research group. The advantage of this style is you're able to be directly matched, so there is space for you in the lab. Unfortunately, it's much more difficult to switch out the lab if it's not a lab you want to work with. And with that, that's the end of this week's episode. Next week, we're going to go into how to get into grad school, where I step-by-step show you how to get into a grad school that you want to get into. So tune in next time. Bye-bye now!